It's Lloyd Banks, the PLK Punchline King. Lloyd Banks, the youngest member of G-Unit, was recruited by 50 from the neighborhood in Queens. 50 had always known about Banks, but didn't really pay him attention when he was younger. But once he got a bit older, he recruited him to G-Unit. Banks, following 50's popularity on the mixtape scene, started to make noise of his own, hence why he got the PLK nickname. Once G-Unit was bubbling and making a lot of noise in the commercial world, Banks kept going on the mixtapes and he won the Mixtape Award in 2004. Probably his most popular and notorious mixtape effort was his victory one on the Biggie Smalls victory song. That's the one people always reference to, even if you're a casual Lloyd Banks fan. And at this point, G-Unit were hot like fire. 50's album already sold like 10 million albums. Then the G-Unit album came out, which was, again, very successful, sold 5 million albums. And then Banks was the first one out of all the other artists to come out of G-Unit after 50. And there was a lot of buzz for his album, and he did not disappoint. But Banks' discography goes like this. The Hunger for More in 2004. And the Hunger for More album was a great success. It went multi-platinum with a couple hits on there as well. Rotten Apple in 2006 was his second effort. It didn't do the numbers. The first one went multi-platinum, but the second one only did like 300,000 at the time. It was actually referenced by Cameron when 50 and Cam got into their beef, when Cam was clowning how much Lloyd Banks sold. His third album was The Hunger for More 2. That came out in 2010. This again was a low-key effort, but it was a strong album. Then Banks took a long time off from music. And in recent years, he came out with a new series of albums called The Course of the Inevitable. He's already had part 1, part 2 and part 3 of these albums. Very strong albums. And it was good to see him back. And Banks has had some underrated hits. On Fire and I'm So Fly on the first album, The Hunger for More. Rotten Apple saw The Cake, Hands Up. Hunger for More 2 had Bieber, Benz and Bentley, that massive song, and Start It Up. And I Don't Deserve You with Jeremiah. In terms of beef, just like the rest of the G-Unit, Banks was frontline, obviously against Ja Rule and even against The Lox. But the most infamous diss song that Lloyd Banks was ever involved with was his one to Rick Ross, and that was called Officer Down. Most people felt this was a scathing diss to Rick Ross. I think that's the reason why Ross always pokes at Lloyd Banks to this day, because it was such a vicious diss and he never really got back at Banks, which I don't think Rick Ross has the skills to do that anyway. But yeah, 50 and Banks' relationship start to deteriorate after a few years. 50 really kind of calling out most of G-Unit in interviews and referring to Banks as lazy, and even saying how he's even got Lazy Lloyd tattooed on his body. 50 even put it in one of his books. Lloyd Banks did respond to 50 on his song Stranger Things on his The Course of the Inevitable album. Most people felt like it was a response to 50, where he says, "Call me lazy, but talent can't be questioned." But Banks always gets respect from his peers. Kanye West even called him underrated back in 2010. Joe Budden's always sang Lloyd Banks' praises as well. Even had him on his podcast, where Banks doesn't really do interviews, but he sat with a whole session with Joe Budden. But what can we say about Lloyd Banks? I think even 50 said that he was going to be the big star in G-Unit. He's had a great career, and I love the resurgence he's having at the moment. But you do get the feeling that Banks didn't really hit his maximum potential as he could have. He had a big buzz at the time when he first came out, and don't quite understand why it actually didn't excel from there. He is quite a reclusive person, so maybe he just wasn't really for the whole limelight thing like 50 was. But what do you think about Lloyd Banks' career? Let me know what your favourite album was, his favourite single was, or maybe you're going back to the mixtapes. Let me know. Leave a comment below. Don't forget to like, subscribe and hit the notification bell. It's Fresh Hip Hop Opinion. Peace and love.